last time we ran into you was at the Rip Magazine 4th year anniversary party at the Palladium.
Yeah.
You guys were just kind of finishing up the record.
Finishing the record, checking out some good bands, you know.
Yeah.
Hanging out at the party.
Yeah. Now, also, your record is produced by Dana Strum from the band Slaughter, and I understand that you guys kind of had to hang tight while they went on the road and wait for them to get back and stuff like that.
Oh, my God. Yeah, craziness. Just the whole process of recording it with Dana was kind of crazy, just because of, you know, obviously his schedule. But, you know, looking back on it, I just wouldn't have done it any differently. I mean, we had so much time to, we did it in 3 different sections. You know, first time we did 3 songs, second time we did like 4 songs, and the third time we did like 7 songs. And mm-hmm. Having so much time in between each time recording, you know, you have the time to you know, write more stuff and just think about what you've done and go back in and kind of, you know, hopefully outdo yourself.
So it was like record a couple songs, take a break while he went on the road and then come back.
Or go out on the road. We spent about 2 weeks out on the road with Dana.
Really? When they were with Kiss.
Yeah, with Kiss, Pastor Pussycat, and hung out with those guys for a couple of weeks. And whenever he had basically a day off, we would just go in to a studio and do some vocals.
So did you record it at a whole bunch of different studios?
All over about 5 different studios, 3 different states.
Great.
Something like that. We'll had a chance to do some vocals in my hometown of Minneapolis. So.
Oh, that's kind of cool. Well, we'll be back in talking to Stephen and Rob from Kik Tracee. And also look out for their new video, Don't Need Rules, that you've, of course, seen on MTV. Yeah. And but right now, some valuable messages that you should watch.
Hi, it's Don Doggett. I'm going to say it this time. Billy White. This guy. Oh, he's so cute.
Oh, yeah.
John Norum.
I have Don Dawkins' phone number. But thanks, guys. We're here back on the Headbangers Ball with Stephen and Rob from the band Kik Tracee. And we're about to play your video, but one thing I just kind of want to talk about. On the new album, you do a cover version of a Simon and Garfunkel song, Mrs. Robinson.
Whoa.
Was that because you were Simon and Garfunkel fans or because you like older women?
A little both. Simon and Garfunkel, we just grew up in that era listening to that kind of thing. And when we were thinking about doing a cover tune, I mean, in L.A., when there's so many bands playing, it's like you want to stick out, you want to do something different. And so we said, let's not do a cover tune like everybody else, let's remake something. Take the lyrics and the melody and rewrite all the music. And Stephen came in and said, what about Mrs. Robinson?
And well, did everybody say, oh, great, yeah, we'll do a Simon and Garfunkel song?
Well, with first scrunched eyebrows, you know, I don't know, man.
I think we got famous at first for doing Cats in a Cradle. We do also a cover of Cats in a Cradle, like on the strip, and it went over so well that I brought in Ms. Robinson, thinking, okay, well, let's do this again, and it was just like, it happened. Yeah, it was. It's one of those songs you just grew. I grew up to. My parents, you know, I heard in the background, the living room or something. You know, people like, you know, just one of those tunes I grew up to hearing in the background.
Now you talked about earlier about playing on the Sunset Strip. You are one of the bands that kind of emerged from the L.A. scene, I guess. But are how many of the bands are from L.A.? Because you said before you were
from
Minnesota.
I'm from Minneapolis originally. Yeah,
Johnny, our drummer's from Houston. And myself and the 2 guitar players, Greg and Mike, are from L.A. here. We actually went to high school together.
Mm-hmm. Did you get together in L.A.? Or
oh, yeah.
Did y'all? Oh, so y'all met out here.
Yeah.
Came to L.A. to become a band.
Yeah!
Definitely. Definitely. Did our thing.
Great. We'll come back and talk to these guys in a little bit. But right now, let's play a video from them. Any way you want to lead into the video? Tell us any great stories about it? Or
No Rules. It's done over at the Los Angeles City Hall. And
took over City Hall courtroom for a day. And
well, next time you go there, there's some records.
Let's do our thing. I gotta say hi to the rest of the guys. Johnny, yo, Broham.
Okay, well, here is the video. Kik Tracee, Don't Need Rules.
No Rules.
Your honor, I moved to make a motion.
That was Kik Tracee, Don't Need Rules on the Headbangers Ball, and Stephen and Rob from Kik Tracee are here. Now, you guys have any plans to go on the road?
Oh, I think, yeah, we have plans to go on the road. With who and when, I don't know, but like I was saying earlier, we're going out on a promotional tour, which is like in stores, and we're going to have, you know, be going out to bowling alleys and having fans come down.
You mentioned bowling alleys. What is the thing about bowling alleys?
Well, we're going to have people come down, you know, like fans and stuff, and like contest winners in conjunction with radio stations and stuff come down and just hang out with the band and bowl, you know.
Just relax, have a good time, just, you know, hang out, really.
Now, I also read somewhere that one of you guys owns an Indian headdress that I guess was worn by Ozzy when he was in Black Sabbath.
That's true.
Yeah, somehow we acquired that through, oh, God, I don't know.
Do you wear it on stage or anything?
Do I wear it on stage? I wear my own headdress on stage in a song called Soul Shaker. I do this, like, kind of rain dance thing, you know, with them.
With the patriotic pants.
Fire, yeah, you know, and the pants and thing going on. But, you know, the headdress, I guess he wore it on the US Festival. Wasn't there something like that?
Yeah, it was the US Festival. We do this, like, tribal vibe, you know.
It's like our big mantelpiece over our TV, kind of sacrilegious.
Cool. Well, thanks a lot for stopping by. And, of course, the new record is out in your stores now.
Yes.
So go out and buy it. And of course, you've seen the video on Headbangers Ball.
We brought you a present for your birthday. We heard it was your birthday. Oh, you can't get out of this. Some more cupcakes.
Here go the ratings now.
Hi, Ricky. This is a birthday present from Kik.
Tracee.
Want to see me blush?
Yeah.
There it is.
Bought you a little shirt there, bud.
Happy birthday, man. There it is.
See me blush.
What can you say, bud?
Next week's my birthday, too, just so you know.
Yeah, right.
Anyways, watch how much your video gets played now. Right now, it's time for us to play a video from Van Halen. They've got a brand new album called, of all things, For Unlawful Carnal Knowledge. Figure out what the abbreviation for that is. And it just hit the streets. And the band says that they're returning to their roots, and you see for yourself. I like the song a lot. It's the first album that they've done in about 3 years, and I know you have all been waiting to see what they do, and this is what they do. Here is Pound Cake from Van Halen. Am I going to get hit by Pound Cake now or something?